Hello everyone and welcome to the news from Shuruq TV. Our headlines are The European Commission for Crisis Management Humanitarian Affairs visits Sudan. The General Assembly of the Commercial Financing Portfolio authorizes the list of portfolio business. Khartoum State announcing the date of the foundation exams tomorrow through a press conference. The European Union mission announced the European Commissioner for Crisis Management and Humanitarian Aid, Mr. Janez Lerandzis, will visit Sudan to prepare the Sudanese Partnership Conference that will be held in Berlin on June the 25th, 2020. It's scheduled that Mr. Janez will meet with Prime Minister Dr. Abdullah Hamdok to discuss international and humanitarian support for Sudan in the coming period. The European Commissioner will accompany the second flight of the European Union's humanitarian airlift to Sudan, as well as a high-level delegation from France, Sweden, and Norway, including the organizations that will resume working in Sudan after stopping during the previous regime. The General Assembly of Shareholders in the Commercial Financing Portfolio approved in its meeting today in the Friendship Hall the list of portfolio business, and the board of directors was elected to it after making some adjustments and adding insurance companies. The leave took place in the presence of all ministers of the economic sector, and the session was chaired by Mr. Salah Manna, member of the Higher Committee for the Management of Economic Crisis. The value of the strategic commodities portfolio exceeds $2 billion, and each of the commercial banks contributes £5.2 billion. A Jinaid company, $100 million, and gold producers and exporters, 3 tons of gold can be increased, in addition to the investment body of Social Security by €16 million, and the number of the banks provide credit lines estimated at $374 million, represented by Al Baraka Bank, Gulf Bank, Bank of Khartoum, Omdurman National Bank, and Faisal Islamic Bank. The Ministries of Education and Health in the state of Khartoum will announce the date of the primary stage exams tomorrow, Wednesday, at a press conference that will be held at 12 noon in the Ministry of Education. This came in the meeting held by the Governor of Khartoum, Dr. Yusuf Adam Abdi, today with the Director General of Education in the state, Mr. Muhammad Ibrahim Ali. It was agreed upon a vision with the Federal Ministry of Health in Khartoum State to take adequate precautions to protect the students from COVID-19, as spacing between students will be applied and sterilization of exam centers before and after the exams. The Joint Central Emergency Chamber of Corona in Khartoum State held a meeting today chaired by Engineer Hatim Abugroun, General Director of the Ministry of Infrastructure and Transportations. The meeting secured the procedures that absorb the people who stuck abroad and praised the efforts of the Ministry of Health to subject the arrivals to the medical examination. The meeting also called to observe the humanitarian aspects for those coming across land and called on all responsible authorities to work hard to solve the medication problem. The meeting also heard enlightenment from the Director General of the Ministry of Industry and Trade on the return of rolls to bakeries, confirming the availability of flour in abundant quantities, but the electric trains affected the bakery work, noting the efforts being made to operate the bakeries with generators. In the context of his current visit to Khartoum, the governor of the River Nile State, Abdul Mahmoud Hamad, held 2 separate meetings where he met the Attorney General Maulana Tagisir Al-Hibir. The meeting dealt with a number of issues, especially the dispute that erupted between the Nuba and Qur'an tribes in the state, and he praised the estimated prosecution efforts to investigate and contain the crisis legally, in addition to following up issues in the state. In the same context, he met with the Chief Judge Maulana Ni'mat Abdullah. The meeting discussed a number of issues concerning the state, and the governor provided a detailed explanation about some of the issues of revenue and collection in the state. The security services of the River Nile State stressed the provisions of the mechanism to follow up in coordination with the competent agencies to intercept the smuggling of gold in mines, which negatively affect the growth of the national economy with some neighboring countries and states. The governor said that River Nile State enjoys full security and stability in spite of the threats and negative secretions that may arise because of the expansion and growth of mining, and he appealed to the director of the agency and citizens stand with the proposals and programs of the state and the government that operate in exceptional circumstances. in the light of economic and health conditions that Sudan was passing through them. Reminding headlines. The European Commission for Crisis Management and Humanitarian Affairs visits Sudan. The General Assembly of the Commercial Financing Portfolio authorizes the list of portfolio business. Khartoum State announced the date of foundation exams tomorrow through a press conference. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was everything for tonight. Thank you for following. See you tomorrow.